If you ever walk students through a particular process or method of study, then workflows are for you. Using custom workflows in Logos allows you to guide students through the steps you suggest for any kind of biblical or theological study. As you'll see, beginning with an established outline makes the process of creating a workflow much simpler. So, if you already have your process outlined or fully fleshed out, continue watching this video. If you still need to sketch out an outline, go ahead and pause here until you're ready to proceed. Now, to turn the process you have in front of you into a Logos workflow, begin by creating a new workflow. All workflows are housed in the Guides menu, and the option to create a new one can be found there. The first screen that opens requires you to choose the kind of workflow you want to create. And as you can see here, once you've selected your workflow kind, you can't change it. These workflow types are based on what you want to study, whether that's a biblical passage, Bible word, theological topic, etc. So you'll want to make sure you choose the right kind of workflow for the process you want to create. Each workflow type includes different options for the major and minor steps that make up the process, because these options are based on the kind of workflow you've created. For example, I have two custom workflows displayed here. The one on the left is a Bible reference workflow, and the one on the right is a Bible word workflow. While both workflows give you the option of adding new major and minor steps, documents, expandable text, etc., notice the number of items listed in the section below text. The items in this section provide access to other Logos guides and tools that are relevant to the kind of study you selected for the workflow. Clearly, there are more guides and tools in Logos that might be useful for studying a biblical reference than there are for studying a biblical word. So, selecting the kind of workflow you want to create will affect the types of tools you can include. Now, since you already have an outline of your process, you can begin to build your workflow. At the top, you can give your workflow a title, adjust the author name if you'd like, and give the workflow a description. These fields will be especially important when we get to the final step of sharing the workflow with your students. Below the general section comes the area where you actually construct your workflow. You'll notice that the workflow begins with an untitled major step and instructions below on how to populate the workflow. When you click the Add button, you'll see that you can add new major steps to the workflow, or add minor steps that break down a major step into smaller chunks. After you've added steps, you'll likely want to add text, or expandable text, describing that step and giving instructions on what it involves. You can also add questions with fields for your students to type in their answers, free response fields with links to share to various social media platforms, and the ability to create docs from within the workflow. Each item you add to your workflow can be reordered through the panel menu. At any point, you can click Done and preview your workflow. To continue editing it, just open the Workflows panel menu and click the option to edit this workflow. But you have more options than just these. Feel free to find a workflow that is similar to what you want to create and model yours on it. This can be a helpful way of finding useful guides and tools to add if you're not yet familiar with all that Logos has to offer. You can also open a guide that corresponds to your workflow to see the sections that populate it. Opening a passage guide, for instance, displays a wealth of options, each of which can be added to major or minor steps in your workflow. So, if your workflow includes looking for parallel passages or examining ancient literature, you can easily add those sections to your workflow. One great feature of workflows is that you can link to Logos resources and external content using hyperlinks. If, for example, you want to direct students' attention to a specific Logos resource, you can create a link to a particular location within that resource as an L4 link. Or, if you want to point students to a website, such as your class's Faith Life group, you only need to add a link. When you're done with your workflow, click Done. Take a few minutes to run through your workflow to make sure it covers what you intended and that your explanations are clear. When you're happy with the result, open the Workflows panel menu and click the Edit This Workflow option. From here, you can share it with your students using the Share button at the top of the workflow template. Here, you have the option of making your workflow publicly accessible or of sharing it with a specific group at faithlife.com. For more on creating groups and sharing documents, see the training videos on those subjects. Remember, you can always edit your workflow if you want to add additional sections or modify existing ones. If you have any questions or need further assistance, we're happy to help.